ETV, and more specifically, welcome back to a rather blustery Brighton. I'm bringing you this video today with an extraordinarily rare car and Omaze. This is an exciting video for a number of reasons. A, I'm going to be discussing replacing my Aventador SV, and also you'll have a chance to win this extraordinarily rare Audi R8 V10 Plus Decennium Edition. And we're going to get into the car, we're going to go through it, we're going to go for a drive, and I'm also going to discuss replacing my SV. I'm going to go through my options. This is one of them. And as I said, somebody will win this extraordinarily rare R8 V10 Plus Decennium. Not only is the car being given away, however, by Omaze, there's also $20,000 in cash. Stay tuned for how to get involved in that. So without further ado then, let's have a little look at this car, and I'm going to go through exactly why it's so special and exactly how you can win.
So then, here we go, ladies and gentlemen. With just $10, you can enter to win this very car with Omaze. The link will be below the video. And what's cool about Omaze is there's a charitable element as well involved. So you'll actually be donating to charity and also entering to win. Mahmood's there, by the way. Hello, Mahmood, how are you doing? Hey. A little bit chilly, isn't it, mate? Yeah, okay. So then, basics first. What is the Decennium Edition? The Decennium Edition was actually brought out by Audi. Goodness me. So then, the Decennium Edition, before that rather rude interruption, was brought out by Audi to commemorate 10 years of the Audi R8. It's an icon in its own right, and this is the 10-year anniversary edition. There were only 222 units of this car produced, and only 10 of them made it to the UK. I believe this is number 40 in total, and it sports a number of very, very cool features. Let's go around. Off the bat then, the Decennium Edition has this satin paint, rather nice indeed, and this has actually got satin PPF on it as well. Very good idea. Also features these exclusive wheels in a rather nice bronzy gold finish. Very, very cool. Got ceramic brakes in there. Everything on the car is dechrome, carbon mirrors. Coming inside the car, you're greeted with Decennium badges there. Very, very nice. And what's very cool, can we see that? Look at that on there. So this is number 40, and that is actually a light coming out of the bottom of the door. Very cool indeed. Inside then, we are greeted with Alcantara on the seat, Alcantara on the wheel, carbon absolutely everywhere, and more Decennium branding there. Very cool as well. We got R8 stitching in there. Coming around the car then, we have more carbon. To apologize for the wind, ladies and gents. Carbon on the wing there. And special for the Decennium Edition, we've also got gold on the engine cover, much like the Performante actually, but this is a bit more goldy. The Performante is a bit more bronze. As with the facelift R8s as well, we've got these huge exhaust pipes as well, reminiscent of kind of, you know, the normal RS models actually, the RS3, the RS6, these big ovals. Super, super cool. We've actually got a very cool V10 plate there, and Tony's initials. Tony is the owner of this car, and we'll talk to Tony shortly. We're gonna go for a little drive.
Right then, let's fire up. Nice. Ladies and gentlemen, this is Tony.
Hello, mate.
How are you doing? It's a very bracing morning, so apologies if we look at a little bit kind of shell-shocked. The wind is pretty aggressive.
Weather beat.
Yeah, so we're going to go for a little spin. I'm going to talk to Tony about the Decennium, how he came to get it, his car history, because it's relatively interesting. Big R8 fan, I think it's safe to say. And then we're going to go through my replacement for the SV. A number of options, and you can chip in on this as well. You can offer your thoughts on the topic. So here we go then, let's get going. I don't know where we are, by the way, so you're gonna have to be a navigator as well.
Yeah, okay, so we're on the lower Madeira Drive, and we're gonna head on into Brighton that way.
Wonderful stuff. Yeah. Off we go then. It's quite civilized in here actually, isn't it?
Yeah, it can be. Your granny could drive it actually.
If she was alive. That's not funny. So first things first then, have you modified this car at all?
No, not at all.
Have you got any plans?
Yeah, it's because it won't rev above 3,500 in a neutral or pop and crackle.
Yeah.
I'm going to have a Capristo put on it next week, actually.
That's the thing with a lot of these modern cars. They've got that. They've got software now that makes them a lot more civilized. They've got petrol particulate filters.
Yeah.
There's a lot less anti-socialness that comes with them.
Yeah.
So I've modified my Pista as well.
Yeah.
For that very reason.
Well, it's the only thing that is lacking, really. Everything else is. Because I had the previous same model, Gen 2, V10, which popped and crackled, and it was fantastic, and I loved it to bits. And a bit disappointed with this when I realised that that was the case with this one. But
yeah, it's the way they're all going. Even there's different even early Pistas this year and later Pistas this year, the later Pistas are quieter, and they're the same car, same generation,
yeah,
but this,
yeah,
they're getting quieter even within the model ranges, which is crazy. So,
well, I've been told that next year they're going to halve the amount of revs it can do in neutral. So
really,
yeah, it's all down to the EU, isn't it, I guess, and saving the planet.
Yeah, saving the planet, sea ice, yeah, polar bears, yeah, turtles.
Gotta be done.
All of that nonsense. So then, back to the start. When did you get this car?
I got it in April. I had a call to say they were coming out. There's only 10 in the UK.
Yeah.
And you had to be pretty quick if you wanted to get your name down. You couldn't just order one. Audi said that they would, only 10 in the UK, so they would pick the dealers that they decided were going to have one. And I phoned up my local Audi dealer, and they couldn't be sure. And a pal of mine said, go to Ipswich Audi, who are fantastic. And and he said, put your name down. We should know in about a week whether we've been lucky. And then I got a call in about a week or 10 days, and they said, they're going to give us one.
So, oh, you won.
So,
secured the bag.
Apparently they were sold out in an hour.
Really?
Yeah, all 10 were gone in an hour, and then they just had to decide who was going to be get one. So.
Well, that's the thing. The R8, it's an icon now. 10 years of it. There are a lot of R8 fans out there. So,
yep.
Super popular car.
Speed limit is 30 miles per hour.
You're also getting updated on the speed limit around here. Tony's got some very clever contraptions we were actually just talking about. It's far too boring for the video, but we're just going through all the stuff he's got going on in here.
Yeah.
Some interesting kit.
Yeah, got to have a bit of help.
Absolutely.
We do have indicators in here, unlike the BMWs.
There'll be BMW drivers now abusing you in the comments. So then, I need your assistance.
Yep.
Replacing my Aventador SV, I have a number of options. Are you a Lamborghini man, a Ferrari man, a Porsche man, a McLaren man?
No, I admire those cars, but I know very little about them, to be fair.
Okay,
but,
me too. I don't have a clue. If you had to pick a supercar brand, other than, of course, Audi, what would be your thing?
Well, to be honest, I've looked at Ferraris, not looked to buying them, but I've looked at them, admired them, and they haven't done that much for me, to be honest, but
yeah,
I must admit, the Pista, I would buy.
Okay.
It is something extra, I think. It's beautiful.
That's
so, in fact, I even mentioned it to a couple of mates, and they went, it won't happen. I haven't got that sort of dough, unfortunately.
Nor do I, but I've got a good finance company.
Well, this is it, Well, this is HP's up the eyeballs as well. So.
Oh, yeah, I'm up. I've got water. Water's about there at the moment with me. I'm at leverage. So, don't you worry about that. If I go down, the economy's going with me, basically. So then, the Aventador SV. I've already got Pista, so that's off the card. I mean, buying two would be stupid even for me.
Yeah.
The options then. I want to go something kind of that level up, so kind of something slightly iconic, maybe something a little bit older. SLS Black Series?
I've had Mercedes. But,
you're a fan of that?
I've had six SL, 500s. I had a SL55, which was...
Oh, really?
Which was a very nice car.
Yeah.
But I've sort of gone away from Mercedes because of Audi. So
Audi.
I don't like the long bonnet, but it's a matter of taste, isn't it? Really?
So then SLS Black Series, that's on the list. They're probably about 400 to 500k.
Yeah.
600 if you find someone that's flying a kite.
That is a lot, isn't it?
That is a lot. Yeah. So in translated, that's probably 100 down, $6,000 or $7,000 a month, something like that, maybe.
Yeah.
that's the way things are priced these days. Also on the list, 599 GTO Ferrari, a little bit older.
Yeah.
Again, you're looking 400, 450 thereabouts. It's the same kind of price range as the SS Black Series.
What colour would you go for? I suppose you might not have a choice.
With these cars, that's the thing. You don't really have a choice. When they come up and there's a nice example, you kind of just have to go with it and love whatever it's about. If you hold out for the right spec, then you're going to be waiting the rest of your life for a lot of these cars.
Yeah.
Also on the list, Murcielago SV. So that is the older generation of the Aventador.
Yeah.
They're actually about 350 thereabouts.
Yeah.
And I think of the lot of the cars, that's going to be the most unusable. That's going to be borderline drivable. Yeah. The Aventador SV around town.
That's undrivable, isn't it?
Yeah, it's pretty appalling.
You can't revert. You can't see what you're doing, can you?
No, you're just in there, just guessing.
Yeah, yeah.
Anything could be going. Anything could be World War 3 outside. You just don't have a clue. Anything past your kind of cheekbone here, that way, no idea.
Nah,
just forget it. What else is on the list? F12 TDF is on the list. Now that's going to be a little bit more expensive. They're between 600 and 700k now on at the low end. As much as I'd love one, I think they're overpriced.
Yeah.
And I think with the A12 TDF GTO, whatever it's going to be, the A12 Superfast lightweight version that's coming out.
Yeah.
I don't know if the F12 TDF is going to happen. I love it, but possibly. The car that I do want the most out of the lot of them.
Yeah.
Carrera GT.
Right. Yeah.
Yeah, you're a fan of that?
Yeah, that's nice.
Yeah, you have that? So those are my options, basically. And I want you all to get in the comments and let me know what you think I should do, what I should get. There's going to be a series. This is the first video of a series of me test driving all of these cars.
We're in the bumpiest road in Brighton, by the way. Just out of interest, I thought I'd bring you up here to see how this car...
It's quite a, quite a good road test, actually. We're doing bumpy roads. It's like Millfield or whatever.
Bad, isn't it?
Or Hill, I don't know.
Yeah, we're going to turn right up here. This is the sort of...
it's actually not too bad, though.
Nah, shocker.
These seats are actually really comfortable as well. So you've got carbon ceramics on here as well.
Yeah.
I noticed they work. I just jumped on them pretty hard there because I'm used to carbon ceramics just not working. There's no heat in them, but they work off the bat, yeah?
Yeah.
And they're not squeaking either.
No, they do when they're cold, but they don't work too well about 190, I've got to tell you.
On a racetrack, of course.
In Germany.
I thought you were about to say on the A3.
No.
No,
I never go above 70.
So you've been to Germany in it?
Yeah, we went on a rally.
Oh, nice.
It was awesome. One day, we drove too long, actually. One day we drove for 14 hours, which was a killer.
That is a lot.
But we did Stelvio.
Really?
Around there, that was amazing. Yeah.
That's nice, this car's been used and not put in a collection somewhere. And kind I've kept with dust on it.
On my Gen 1 R8, I put 75,000 miles on it.
Joking.
Yeah.
Wow. Well, hats off to you, because not many people do that, and I'm guilty of that. Yeah. I keep the miles down on all my cars.
Yeah.
I'm pretty bad like that. And the audience, they tell me off so much for that. Drive your cars more.
Well, this has done 7,500 in 6 months, so getting on that one.
Wow, you've had a good time. Yeah. That's what they're for at the end of the day. I mean, but there will be these just sat in collections. Just people that just hoarded them. Visibility and kind of just drivability in these things is just great.
Yeah.
I don't feel stressed. Most supercars you get in, you're just a little bit kind of perturbed driving around town, but this is just it's just great.
Right then, you lot, the RA is now back, safe and sound. I did not shunt it. I'm probably more likely to get blown away than anything. As I said at the beginning of the video, make sure you check out the links below. Enter to win this very car. It might not be this actual car, but it'll be an R8 V10 Plus Decennium Edition with $20,000 in cash. At the same time, there's also a charitable element as well. Amazer helping people throughout the world. All the details will be below regarding the charity and all the amazing work that your entry and donation will help. As I said then, this was a very quick intro to a new series that I'm starting, the SV Replacement Series. I'm going to take out all of those iconic cars that I mentioned in the chat in the car, one by one, a video on each. I'm going to find some driving roads and put together some really, really nice videos for you lot. And then I'm going to decide what I replace the SV with finally. So do stay tuned for that. Thank you so much for watching. A huge thanks to Tony who's over there, and I'll see you all very, very soon. Don't forget to check out Amaze. Ciao for now. Bye now.